Oh, hello everyone, I'm back. When I came into the Night Elf area in Teldrassil, I missed a quest. And I didn't realise it was from Krennen. And that might sort of explain why it felt the ending of the Worgen quest was a little bit lackluster, so I'm going to complete it now.
Well met.
So, the Howling Oak. So this is it, our new home. I'm not sure if I'll ever feel like it truly, if I truly have a home again. We mustn't be unappreciative of what the Night Elves have offered to us, though. Their race is not one to throw out idle welcomers, to just anyone. It is true, it is a true testament to faith and generosity that they're taking us again. They're taking us in. Jesus. Gwen and Greymane are in the city proper, at the Howling Oak. You should stop by, take the portal beneath the tree north of us, and then seek out the Howling Oak in the northern portion of the city. No, yeah, I should probably grab that.
We live another day.
Odd jittering. Is that over there? Oh no, I can't go through there. So hopefully this ends up tying up the sort of the loose-ended feeling that I had from when we completed the storyline. Huh. Swift mountain horse. Interesting. Lots of horses. Oh. Mountain horse. Swift mountain horse. Apparently she doesn't talk. Okay. Let's have a look. There's Gen, and there is Gwen. Hello there. And let's go to human form, because why not?
The Alliance has done us a great service. For this, I am eternally grateful.
This oak was grown through the aid of the druids from a seed taken back on Gilmaeus. It stands for all that we're endured and all that we've accomplished. May it serve to remind us that our curse is also our blessing. It seems you have your first charge. You must travel back down to Rostraren village where we first arrived and speak to Vespratus to secure a ride to Lador. Oh, wait a minute, Tyrande? What's she doing here? I hope my people have been welcoming to you. These are burdened times, so I fear much will be needed. Not at all, priestess, we're very grateful to all that you have offered us here. When we spoke previously, you offered to repay the favor. I might have to act on it. There's trouble in Lord Danel, a village of ours across the waters, as Lord Theron. If any of your people can be spared, I fear war encroaching upon us in Kalimdor. I know the perfect people for such a task, it will send them immediately, priestess. Thank you again. I'm glad to see such a poise and composure from your people. Perhaps your curse. Perhaps your curse does not define you after all, Tyrande says. We will take our leave again. Welcome to you all. Huh, okay. That's a bit nice. Okay. So once in Lord Danel, aid the Night Elves in any way you are able. I'm trusting you to treat them with the reverence that they deserve in light of all they have done for us. I must travel to the distant city of Stormwind to meet with King Anduin. I hope to see your face again very soon, Alfred. Until then, a fond farewell. Okay. Well, that sort of was a better ending. Alright, well, I'll go down there. We might as well end up in Darkshore. Wispy sounds. Run. No, I'm just gonna change some of these settings in here. System. Let's drop graphics a little bit. That might make it slightly less glitchy. Okay. So, where are we to go? There we go. What are you? Who are you? Vespristus. Vespristus. Fair enough. So there's Ordinal Darkshore. That's odd, I'm getting some weird graphics. So look at that. Don't think that should be happening like that. It almost looks like it's shadowing. Well, I recently reinstalled Windows again, so maybe there's something not quite right with it. I might just get here and pick up some of the quests. And, and see if I want to take it further or sort of play around with these graphics. Looked fine before when I was testing it. Okay, so there's there we go, speak to secure right. Well, I did. Oh, wait a minute.
Hello.
Did I do that right?
Del Nod.
Oh, I'm gonna have to go back. Breaking waves. Oh. Okay, that's really odd. Graphics are very strange. System. Oh, yep. So, yep. Let's just drop that down. Let's just do that. See if that helps at all. Can I actually talk to you?
Greetings.
No.
Delnadris.
Well, that was a mistake. Little howling there. So what have we got? Yeah, I'm not sure about having that on. Over that. Because at the moment, I'm still going as a balanced druid. And I'm just going to sort of see how it plays now that I've got a couple more spells. And see if it's any more fun. If it's not, then I think I will change over to Feral. Or maybe even Guardian. But Feral's probably the best way to go. Okay, so. Breaking waves of change. Our allies have come to our aid. Thank you, Alun. Tyrande was wise to extend open arms to your people. We need help. We need everyone we can get.
Go in peace.
It's too late for Laird. He didn't make it in time. The last wave of Night Elves from Aberdeen attempted to escape a couple of hours ago. They stayed in their old homes, clinging to hope they would be salvaged. It seems they were finally forced out. I fear many of them won't make it, like Laird did not. Quickly, go down the coast to the west and find any survivors that you can help. We're sending sentinels and hippogriffs down, but every moment counts. We need to know which ones might make it. Okay.
A shark below.
Alright, so we'll nip on down there. So who's this? There you are. We need able bodies as fast as possible. Lives depend on it.
I am honored.
So what about Linda Malshi? So some of the survivors of this Uberdine attack are still trying to make up the coast to safety. We only caught word that they were coming within the last hour. I wish that we had more warning. The coastline west of us is swarming with vile spray. Vicious little water elements. We need to clear them out if any of the survivors are to have a chance of making it to Lord Danel. Yep. Depart immediately and kill every elemental you see.
Goddess, watch over you.
Okay. And we will speed that up. There's a little vile spray at water elements, but we're going to do that over here. Excellent. Okay. There we go. So that's the sentinels.
It's too far away.
And like that, we're gonna grab four little wild sprays that we can. Let's see. Volkov's body lies motionless. As you begin to move away, a hand reaches out and grabs your ankle. He's alive. Fantastic. There's a sentinel. What have we got? Ah. Serlin Whiteclaw approaches. He was only grasp of breath. He looks sad. Chance rescues. Okay, cool. And bingo. Fantastic. Little annoying water sprays. Lunar Strike. Well, that's not too bad. Who have we got? Shaldin? Aw, oh, come on, let me on the rock. Okay, so rescued her. Whisper escapes, throw it as you approach. Help, please. There we go. My last one.
I need to get closer.
Well, quickly means quickly when I'm done. Oh. Bathurst Moonshade's gone. But Night Whisper's alright. There we go. Bingo. Let's run back. Yeah, I don't remember this village in Vanilla at all. Where is it? I think Ubadon was like there somewhere.
How may I help?
Your efforts are very much appreciated since the cataclysm. The elements have been out of control. We have little hope of taking back Ubadon without extinguishing their presence first.
Good luck.
Oh, I've unspent talent. So what do we got? Force of Nature. Summons a stand of three treants for 10 seconds, which immediately taunt and attack enemies in the targeted area. Your next three Lunar Strikes are instant cast. Let's click to summons. Or Star-Lord. Lunar and solar empowerments also reduce the time, the cast time of their affected spells. Seconds. Trance. I'll take that. Got some Lunar Strike and they're reasonably hard hitting. And I can do dungeons. So what have we got? Dead Mines, Rage Fire Chasm, and Levy Caves.
Peace be with you.
Thank you, Druid. Some of them surely would not have made it without you. We'll be taking the wounded to the main building once we have them all safely back in town. Perhaps you can meet us there later. And bring word, bringing word of more survivors incoming. We're doing everything we can to swift the ones that are still there. Please send any help you can. Understood. Send and return to the beach and aid them bring around across process. Okay. Yeah.
May the stars guide you.
Surrendia Oak Whisper.
Greetings.
It's good to see you. You were key in ensuring that our loved ones made it home, and I hold some hope that you may yet help us further. Like Laird, their wounds will be grave, every one of them battered by the coast and assaulted by the elements. I'm doing what I can, but it seems that those elements hosted a toxin that is weakening their ability to heal. I believe I can concoct a stave, a salve. I will need secretion from muscles of the clams that inhabit the coast. Can you help me?
Elune might your path.
Probably. Oh, got a bunch more. So, when the wounded arrive, we'll be putting them up in the inn while we tend to their recovery. Please find us where you want to okay up. So, oh. Ah. Interesting. Aye. Whiz bang, crank toggle.
Oh. Greetings.
I think he was from the first one before. Ah, the buzz boxes. Ah, yes, those little boxes. Okay. Greetings, I'm helping Tharnarian. Here, try to unravel what's been corrupting the wildlife in the area. I'm setting up some machines in the field that can analyze animal parts and possible corruption agents. If you can get me some good samples, we can get to the bottom of this affliction quickly. The first machine is Buzzbox 413. I set it up on the beach, just east of town. I'll need you to gather some flesh from the nearby corrupted tide crawlers and bring it to the machine so that I can analyze it.
Off and away.
So just get a whole bunch of flesh from the tide crawlers. Okay. Ah, that's one of my own. So, what does he want?
What can I do for you?
Ah. Okay, so between boat rides and building, I'm exhausted and hungry. You know what sounds tasty? Fish. Fish sound delicious. Darkshore is known for its groper. If you fish me up some, I'll make it worth your time. Fishing pole.
Right. We are bound by a common enemy.
Okay. Okay, let's go down there. That's not too bad. Not picking up anything. Oh, there's loads of clams here. Loads of them.
I can't loot that right now.
Oh, I'm looting all these ones right now. Kills the fish. Lots of little clams. Get some clams, get some clams, get some clams. I have lots of clam meat. Get some clams. Ah, more clams. It's not too bad. Let's get some of these going.
I'm out of range.
We're going to do that thing. Really then. Just get a little bit of health. And we had literally one piece of flesh out of that. That's gonna take some time to grab.
It's too far away.
Oh, a bit sad music. Okay, so that's two.
I need to get closer. It's too far away.
Oh, I sound like a dog. Well, I guess that makes sense. So let's go. Still one. Let's go out from here.
I'm out of range.
not dropping really well, are they?
I need to get closer.
Oh, snap. Oh, my health is not too good. Okay, cool. Excellent. Let's go to this buzz box. So buzz box 413 hums at your expectantly. Machine crackles loudly and then whiz bang, static ridden voice becomes audible. Lovely. I hope you didn't kill too many of them. We're not trying to wipe out the population. We just need to get the source of this corruption quickly. Proceeding with the analysis now. Well, we killed loads of them. Okay, so interesting. The source of this corruption definitely came from something external. Not surprising. No surprises there. It appears that in this case, they've been eating something foul. A large mammal, probably. Most likely a bear. Search the beach for a bear carcass for me. Slightly east of there would make the most sense. On the inland side of the beach, bring me the sample back to town. Okay, so bear over here. Bear. There's the bear.
I'm out of range.
Going to get some, pick up some bits. And then I'll get to the bear. Ah, that's a tower that was there. Had some highborn in it or something. Okay. Got bear carcass, take that back to town. I'm going to fish up these four gropers and then I'm going to hand these in, and I think that will probably do it for the time being. So what have we got here? Gunnice champion. Ah, okay. So that's for my tabard. Yep. Now I'll probably speed this little bit up. Now the one thing they could do is put some little water mechanics in so that you get pulled where there is current. That'd be quite good. So let's move to, let's get the fishing rod, let's do the bauble, and then I'm gonna fish for 5 or 10 minutes. Actually, I think I'm just going to pause it here. Okay, I am back, and I've got the gropers. Oh, just quickly reset out there. So we've got the gropers.
We've been walled up for far too long.
Jonathan's belly grumbles as you approach. Couldn't have said it better with words. It looks like fishing's your thing. My belly appreciates the gift. I'm thinking you would get more use out of this pole than I would. Have at it.
Watch your back.
Interesting.
Welcome back. Did you find the bear sample that I was looking for? That definitely looks like the stuff they were eating. Let me take a closer look. There are a couple of other forms of wildlife that we've been verified infected. It's actually good news that the crabs appear to have caught this from the bears. Hopefully that means that this all stems from one source. We need to focus our attention on those bears now. Box 723 is near the waterfalls to the east. It's going to be messy work, but it's necessary. You'll need to bring some fresh bear guts to that buzz box for analysis. We'll go from there once we have more information.
You have a great day now!
Okay. Let's have a look.
Goddess, bless you.
Alright, Serendia. Did you bring mussels from the clams? I worry that our time grows very short. I did. This will do perfectly. Thank you so much. I suspect they will want to thank you personally should they recover. So perhaps you can stop by later on. Ah, okay. Let's have a look. There's Dentaria.
Elun be with you, Ishnu Dardir.
Ishnu Dardir.
Spalkor. Oh.
I can't use that.
Ah, well, that won't help. Can I get to that? No. Oh, well, it doesn't matter. Okay. Well, I think I might just leave it here. Okay. Until next time, see you later.